Hi guys, welcome to my channel. Today I will be doing a video on the blue C four position selector switch with AFD or alternator field disconnect capabilities. This model number is 9002E. So let's get into the review. This switch is rated at 350 amps continuous power draw and it's a maximum of 32 volts DC. The casing of this switch is constructed from very sturdy plastic, which gives it a great look and feel of quality. The switch is four position in the off position, battery bank 1, battery bank 1 and 2, battery bank 2. Basically what that does is it isolates different battery banks towards your load without cutting your load off. So it's make before break. So if I were to click it to battery bank 1, there it would isolate battery bank 2. If I were to put it to battery bank 1 and 2, it would draw current from both battery bank 1 and battery bank 2. And if I were to put it to battery bank 2, it would isolate battery bank 1 and back to the off position. So it's make before break, as I said. So what it does is that if you have your load onto it, it would not disconnect your load while switching to another battery bank. It would keep your load on. One of the main reason, or the main reason for me to buy this switch. It also have the knob. It take a great amount of force to turn the knob. So if you listen carefully, you would hear the clicks. That click there is the alternator field disconnect switch that is on. That's in when it's in position to battery bank 1, and you heard the click there. And it would go again to battery bank 2, 1 and 2, sorry, and then battery bank 2. And here you hear the alternator field disconnect there again and back to 1. So it's a nice looking switch. The switch is about 4 inches square and 3 inches high. They have 4 mounting holes which are 3 inches apart. I will now take a look at the connection at the back of the switch. At the back of the switch, you have the three main terminals, which is the two input terminal as well as the one output terminal. The input terminals is about 2 inches away from the output terminal, and the two input terminals is about 1.5 inch away. So it gives you a lot of room. Also, the opening where the cables would pass through, it's open on three sides, and it's the opening is about 2 inches. So you have a lot of room there as well to pass cable. The studs are tin plated copper studs. So it's constructed for maximum connectivity as well as corrosion resistance. And the studs are about 22 mm long. So you could add multiple cable terminals here. They would accept M10 or 3/8 cable terminal rings. Switch would accept a maximum of 4/0 AWG battery cables. Those are very huge cables. The switch is also constructed for weatherproof, so which means you could install it outdoor as well without any difficulty. The switch in itself, the connections or the studs at the bottom of the switch, it's when it's in a flat surface, it would be about 1/4 inch from the base of the switch. I'm not sure if you would be able to see it there. Also, the switch have various mounting position, which is two mounting position in that you could, if this here were your mounting board, you could put it as is here and it would be considered the rear, or sorry, the surface or front panel mounting. You could also mount the switch in the rear position. Basically what that means, if I could use this here as a guide, you would see your switch looking something like this here. Basically this is the part at the top here you would see, and this part at the bottom here would be at the back of your board, your mounting board or wall. I am not too very familiar with the alternator field disconnect and what it does, but I think what it does is that it disconnects your alternator and ignition from, sorry, disconnect the power from your alternator or ignition so that it doesn't damage them. So it have two smaller screws here. I would post close-up pictures of this at the end of the video so you would have more detailed look of it. I do apologize for the quality here. I'm using my phone camera to do my video. You have two, which is the F1 and the F2. I think the F1, yes, the F1 goes to your regulator and the F2 goes to your alternator. So it helps to protect your ignition as well as your alternator. This switch, it is advisable to turn off your equipments, your engine, whatsoever you're using. I would be using it on my inverter. So it's advisable to turn your equipment off before switching to the off position. Also on insulation, it's advisable or it's recommended that you disconnect the positive battery terminal before you do your insulation. It's a very nice looking switch, as I said. Very sturdy plastic and construction. I would now post some close-up shoot of the switch so you could have better detailed view of it. Hi guys, I trust that my video has been very helpful for you and for your project that you would be doing. If you like my video, please give me a thumbs up and please subscribe to my channel. I will also do an insulation video for this switch. It would be a temporary insulation between my battery bank and my two battery banks and my inverter. So I trust that you would check that out as well. Thank you for watching.